Hey everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about Wien's displacement law. We'll talk about what this law is specifically and give some examples for its use cases. Okay, so in the previous video we talked about Planck's distribution law, which in short essentially tells us that black and gray bodies emit radiation not just at a single wavelength, which is called the monochromatic or spectral emissive power, but over a wide range of wavelengths. Well, okay, this makes sense, right? For example, let's say that we have this black body here, and remember that a black body absorbs all ranges of radiation, but it also emits radiation at all wavelengths as well. But wouldn't it be useful to know at what specific wavelength we can achieve the highest emissive power for a given temperature? So, stated another way, what specific wavelength will give our black body the largest emissive power for a certain temperature? Well, that is what Wien's displacement law helps us with. Wien's displacement law states that the wavelength that produces the largest flux of radiation times the absolute temperature of the body is equal to 2898 micrometers Kelvin. Therefore, from this equation, it is evident that increasing the absolute temperature of our body, the wavelength that dominates its emission will shift to smaller wavelengths. Let's think of an example where you may have seen this before though. Let's imagine that we are looking at the coils on the top of a stove in the dark. Now, obviously with the lights off and the stove off, we're not going to see anything. Because the metal in the coils is only at room temperature, and as we know, every object above absolute zero emits some radiation, we could have an emission distribution curve that looks something like this. So, as we can see here, our emission curve is relatively wide and clearly not in the visible light spectrum, which I've denoted here. Now, let's say that we turn the stove on. As time progresses, you will notice that the stove eventually begins to glow a dull red color. This is called the Draper point, and this is the point at which all solids glow a dull red. It is roughly equal to 525 degrees Celsius. But how does Wien's displacement law explain why our metal coil is now suddenly visible in the dark? Well, to answer that, let's look back at the law. We stated that as the temperature of our body increases, then the wavelength that offers the maximum flux of radiation is going to get shorter. Therefore, as the temperature in our coil, or any object for that matter, increases, the curve will get displaced to the left, that is to shorter wavelengths, and upwards, towards higher emissive powers. Well, this makes sense, right? As our body is heating up, our curve is moving towards the visible spectrum, which is the wavelengths that our eyes can receive and understand as various colors. So, in theory, if we could heat up our stove coils crazy hot, we would see that the colors shift from red to yellow to green to blue, and then eventually to violet, which would be the shortest wavelengths that our eyes can receive before the maximum radiation flux enters the ultraviolet region. Another example of these curves is the human body. Now, obviously we humans aren't glowing to the naked eye, however, if you observe humans or most mammals under an infrared camera, you would see people glowing as the emission curve will peak in the infrared region. As a final example, let's think about stars. As we have previously talked about, the absolute temperature of a body can aid us in understanding the emissive flux of radiation from that body. Therefore, the color of that body can also tell us approximately how hot that body is. This is how we can roughly understand how hot other stars are being burned at. We know that blue stars are going to be much, much hotter than red stars based on this law, which is really cool. So, in summary, the Wien's displacement law is an equation that helps us understand how emissive power curves change with the absolute temperature of a given body. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding about what the Wien's displacement law is and what it is used for. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.